Hey everybody, welcome back to Wine Up TV. I'm your host with my co-host, Monique, the wine princess. And on today's show, what we're going to do is we're going to talk about Zaca Mesa. Just got some samples in the mail. Been there many times. I'll tell you what, if nobody's ever been to the Central California coast, you have Solvang, you have Santa Maria, and you have Buellton. It's an awesome place. That's where I actually filmed part of Sideways. So when we come back, we're going to taste Zaca Mesa's wines in a second. How was your weekend?
It was great. It was full of wine.
Full of wine? What did you do this weekend? Anything exciting?
Wind up. I drank a lot of whiskey, had some tastings going on. Again, a lot of drinking.
Yeah. You know what? Anything that involves drinking, good-looking chicks, I'm all about that. And that's what we do here at Wine Up TV. Matter of fact, we're kind of going in a little different direction because now Monique's going to start filming a lot of shows with me, and it's just going to increase both of our businesses. And she does a lot of tastings, guys. And what is your website?
Tasteourwine.com.
Tasteourwine.com. Check out Monique. When she's not doing her thing, she'll be over here filming some shows. So this is pretty exciting. Well, today we have Zaca Mesa. And Zaca Mesa, I've been there several times. I used to live in L.A. and then moved to Pasadena. And then I used to drive the 2.5 hours up to Central California. It's a beautiful drive, and there's some great wineries. Not only Zaca Mesa, there's Beckman, there's Curtis Winery. There's probably 30, 40, 50 different wineries. And Foxen, we're going to do some Foxen wines here in a little while, too. Foxen's great as well, little tin shed off the little road. It's a great old-school feel, and their wines deliver. And these two wines we'll talk about, the first wine, this is going to be the 2009 Viognier from Santa Ynez Valley. And this is all estate-grown bottles, so they grow all their own grapes for this wine. And one thing with Viognier is the color. And Viognier is, of course, a grape from the northern Rhone region of France, and they can be made in several different styles. A lot of them tend to be a little flabby on the mid palate that I've had. I haven't had this one yet, so let's give this a whirl and a little smell. You know what I love about this? A little bit of oak. I got that little bit.
And the pear, of course, makes an appearance.
Yeah, but it's a little bit of alcohol as well on the nose. What are you thinking? Oh, she's thinking. Is she cute? She's thinking.
The nose on it isn't too much. It definitely isn't overpowering to me. It's a little weak. A Viognier traditional Viognier will be more dry, actually, especially on the finish, but have a floral nose.
Some of them might have a little floral to them, absolutely. This one here, this is bone dry.
Yes.
This is bone dry.
Yes, it is.
And just, it's got a nice lingering finish, too. You know, some Viogniers are a little flabby in the middle. They kind of, once you swallow them, they just kind of cut off really quick. This one actually has a little bit of body, a little bit of character.
It does.
Kind of like her.
It is an acidic finish on it, and it does kind of just sit there. But dry for the most part, so they wanted to stick to traditional.
Well, one thing with the 09, very warm vintage. I know it was warm here in Oregon, mm-hmm. and it was warm also in Central California mm-hmm. and Northern California. This is one of those years where things just got a little bit overripe, if you will.
Viognier is really good with salads, with like pasta dishes. It is typically a spring summer lunch wine. So
yeah, you know. Again, people drink Sauvignon Blanc, they'll drink, you know, Pinot Gris, some Chardonnay. This is just kind of like a standalone wine on its own. A lot of people have a hard time pronouncing Viognier. It's Viognier, and not a lot of production on this wine. I'd be surprised if this is over 1,000 cases. I did not look up
how many. It is a boutique vineyard, so it definitely
is. They don't make a lot, and I know they do a couple of their Syrahs. We're going to have one of their Syrahs here, the 07 Syrah. But they also do a couple of high-end Syrahs. They're just like very small production stuff. And that's always really cool. All right, so let's talk about the Syrah. Now, one thing you'll notice in California, look at that color. One thing you notice in California is there are a lot of, Randy Graham especially started it all off with Bonnie Doon. It's like the Rhone Rangers, you know, the Rhone varietals, Viognier, Syrah, Marsan Roussan, Mouvet. All these really interesting grape varietals that make some fantastic wines that hold up to the heat. And as we move forward, even Eastern Washington wines, Yakima Valley, Red Mountain, Horse Heaven Hills, all that, and through the the Columbia Valley, they're starting to plant a lot more red Rhone varietals. And I think the grape of the future for Washington State, Grenache. Grenache. You know, they do a lot of Syrah, and I'd say Syrah is rocking it from Washington State, but I think Grenache is really going to be that spicy fruit bomb. You know, some vineyards in Washington State grow Zin. To me, Zinfandel says
California.
Yeah, good. Yeah.
The best Zins come from California.
They do, and I'm a rocking it when it comes to Zins.
Absolutely.
I mean, love them.
Paso Robles, actually.
It's hot there. One thing, if you ever travel down there, it's the Zinfandel cluster itself can be very large. So when it doesn't ripen evenly. Some will be raisiny, some will be still green, and some will. So you want the average sugar, the bricks in the cluster to be a certain percent. But that's Zinfandel. So we're talking about Syrah.
Walla Walla typically does really good calves, but we'll see.
No, they do. They rock on their calves and their Merlots as well. You know, the grape varietal that everybody kind of bashes still.
So. This Syrah, the nose, I was not.
You don't like this nose?
I don't like the nose.
I like this nose. It's
I'm
meaty.
I'm unimpressed.
It's meaty.
It is actually very deceiving because when you taste it. I mean, this is definitely a food wine. I don't think it has a lot of texture to it.
Good tannins.
Good
acid.
Good tannins.
It's a pleasant wine. You know, I give this.
I would definitely serve ribs with it. Any type of meat, as far as maybe doing a carne asada, would be kind of a fun dish to do.
There you go. You know, also, you know, this wine was just open. Kind of let it air out a little bit, aerate, you know.
But I get the cherry from it. It definitely has a little bit of that spice kick to it.
It does. It has.
The spice is nice. The spice is very nice.
Yeah, it's kind of like a seven spices going on.
Oh, yeah.
Cardamom, a little cinnamon.
Syrah is that sexy halter top that you see a girl walk in.
You got to get one of those here pretty soon for the show.
I know it. You know? I know it.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, we're going to have a. Maybe we'll do a little wet t-shirt concept.
Oh, there you go.
That would look great in a wet t-shirt. Yeah, right? Stop throwing wine on her, just start spilling shit all over her. That's the kind of guy I am, right?
We could line up the females and do that.
I can see that sexual harassment suit coming in the mail any time now. Yes. I noticed. Real men swallow the wine too. I know this. You're.
That's true. Oh yeah.
I'll throw it out there.
Well, this is definitely a romantic color.
It is.
This is a sexy color.
Yeah, this is really. They've really extracted well on this Syrah. Of course, Syrah is one of those great varietals that is heavy enough to bring out a lot of extraction.
Yes, and this will taste really good the next day. This definitely, I can see this developing.
That's a good point. You know, living here in Pinot Country is I'll open a bottle of Pinot Noir, and like what Monique said, this wine will taste good the next day. Some people say, well, some of these Pinots taste better the next day. I completely disagree.
I agree, yeah.
Pinot Noir is a very elegant, sexy, racy grape varietal,
yes.
And it should be consumed that day.
Yes, it should.
Don't let it sit overnight, yes. As you would a Syrah, Cabernet, or a Merlot, or a Bordeaux. Those wines actually get better the next day. A Pinot Noir wouldn't get better the next day. So anyway, this wine, geez, you know what? I don't even know these prices. However, I will definitely find out for you. I have to do a little bit more research and see what's available.
For you, the price is right.
Oh, it always. And you know, guys, you know how I price my wines here? I go on winesearcher.com, and I also go on wine.com, and my wines are always less expensive than their wines. Monique, here's to a fruitful future. Guys, you wait till some of these shows are coming up. We're going to start doing some of these outside. Clothing optional.
Yeah.
That'll scare the audience away. Anyway, it's great to have you on again. And until we see each other next time, remember, what are you going to tell these guys? Anything? Anything important? Right now, you're in the spotlight.
Uncork that bottle and start drinking.
Amen. Guys, we'll see you in a while.